and today I'm going to share with you how I crocheted this multicolored cardigan. I've always wanted a rainbow cardigan, but I couldn't find any that I actually liked for me to buy, so I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna make my own. And if you want to make your own rainbow cardigan, you're going to need an array of colors, starting with red, orange if you have orange yarn, then yellow, then green, then blue, then purple. And the reason that you need them in this order is because there actually is an order to the rainbow. It's Roy G. Biv, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and indigo, and then violet, but pretty much purple. So yeah, these are pretty much the colors, minus the orange, just because I didn't have orange. And I got all of these from Walmart, actually. They're the Red Heart Super Saver 100% polyester yarn, size 4. I think that's all the information you guys always ask me in the comments below. And yeah, so let's get started. So you may be thinking that crocheting a cardigan will be difficult, but in fact, it's just rather tedious. Like, it's going to take a really long time and a lot of yarn, but it's not that hard. And I'll actually draw out the pieces that we need because they're all pretty much rectangles, and it's going to be really easy as long as you get this step down. So I'm going to first make a slip knot with my red yarn, and then chain a chain that is long enough to cover my back. Now I do want this to be a chunky sweater, so I am going to crochet it so that it's wider than my back, but if you want this to actually hug your back, then you just make a chain, then you measure it along from one side of your back to the other side, and once it covers, then that's how many chains that you need. And yes, you may notice right away that I'm not like any other crocheter who actually like genuinely knows how to crochet the right way, because when I was 9 years old, I taught myself how to crochet. And I don't mean taught myself how to crochet as in like I watched YouTube videos or I bought a book to teach me how to crochet. Like, I sat in a room by myself and taught myself how to crochet. So my methods are rather unconventional, but a lot of people seem to really like the way that I teach. However, a lot of people are also very frustrated by the way that I teach, and if you're the latter, then I'm sorry, but I just want to let you know ahead of time that this is the way I teach. I don't give you the exact number of chains. I leave it up to you depending on your preference and body type. That's how many chains that you're going to make. And in order for you to figure these things out, you just have to measure your own body. So alrighty then, after you have chained a chain that's long enough to cover from one side of your back to the other, we are going to start off our first row by going into, say, the third stitch, and then creating a double crochet into that stitch. And a double crochet is yarn over through the stitch, yarn over through two loops, yarn over through the last two loops. And within that same stitch, you're going to go ahead and make three more of those for a total of 4 double crochets inside of one stitch. So this is my third double crochet in this one stitch, and then my fourth double crochet in this one stitch. And you're going to be left with a little cluster like this. It looks kind of odd in the beginning, but as we build and build and build, it all makes sense. So from here, we're going to then chain one, skip 3 stitches, go into the fourth stitch, and then create 4 double crochets inside of that one stitch. So again, it's yarn over through the stitch, yarn over back through the stitch, yarn over through two loops, yarn over through the last two loops. Yarn over through a stitch, yarn over back through a stitch, yarn over through two loops, yarn over through the last two loops. And now you could see the design a little bit better. I mean, the end is still kind of wonky, but as we build on top of it, it'll make more sense. And yeah, just going to do that throughout the rest of the row. So then chain one, skip 3 stitches, 1, 2, 3, go into that fourth stitch, and then create 4 double crochets inside of that one stitch. And again, you're just going to continue with that pattern until you reach the end of the row. So I will go ahead and continue with this and meet you at the end. Alrighty, so I've reached the end of the row here. I've already chained one, and now I'm going to go into the very last stitch, because once I skip 3, this is the fourth stitch, so it worked out perfectly. So I'm just going to create my cluster of double crochets inside of this one stitch, And after I've created the fourth one, then I'm going to chain one, flip the project over, and start my new row. But first, let me show you how it's supposed to look like. So it should look something like this. And after you've created the first row, we're just going to go ahead and make a second row on top of it with the same color. So again, I've already chained one, but I'm actually going to chain two more. And then reach on over to the opening in between the clusters and create another cluster of four double crochets inside of that opening. And that's going to make the little checkered pattern that you saw with my intro showing off what the cardigan actually looks like. I hope it looks good. Again, I have not finished it yet. This is all live, me making it. And if you are watching this video right now, then I think it looks good, which is great. This is my first cardigan that I'm going to ever make, and I decided to make it with a whole bunch of different colors. How funny is that? It would probably be so much easier if it was all one color, or if this was like a solid design, but I went ahead and I wanted to use this stitch along with a bunch of different colors. So I did make it difficult on myself, but I think that it's going to be worth it, and hopefully the cardigan looks awesome. But anywho, so again, I'm just continuing with that pattern. I'm just making four double crochets inside of each opening, and after I have created four double crochets inside of an opening, I chain one, then reach on over to the next opening and create four double crochets in that opening as well. And I'm just going to continue doing this until I reach the end of the row once more. And after I've reached the end of the row, then I'll show you how I change colors. Okay, so I've reached the end of my second row, so I'm just going to chain one. And from here, I'm just going to make a double crochet at the very end of the row just to make it even. And that's how I'm going to end the row. And this is what my first color looks like. Woohoo! So now I'm going to show you how I'm going to switch to the next color, which is yellow. So I'm going to cut the yarn from the yarn ball, leaving a decent amount of yarn left over because it's going to make it easier for me to put the two colors together and then just crochet with them both. Now, of course, you can attach the new color any way that you like, but this is just the way that I do it. So yeah, I put both colors on my hook and then I crochet with them at the same time. It is a little bit messy, but after the project is over, or rather after I'm done crocheting the project, I go back and I cut all the loose yarn. So yeah, so from here, after I've attached the new color, I'm just going to continue with the new row. So in this first opening that we created in the previous row, I'm going to make my four double crochets with yellow, and then I'm going to chain one, reach on over to the next opening and crochet my four double crochets inside of that opening. And after that, I'm going to again chain one, reach on over to the next opening, and so on and so forth. And really, that's all you need to know for practically the entire project. You need to know this pattern, like how to make the openings and the four double crochets, and then how to switch colors, and that's pretty much it. That's pretty much all you need to know for this project. So again, it's relatively easy to do, but it's going to take you a very long time, especially if you want a chunky cardigan like mine. I like my cardigans like loose fitting, so that's why it's so chunky. But of course, you can have like a tighter fitting cardigan if you like. Again, it's totally up to you and your preference. Whatever you'd like, you can do. I don't give like specific number of chains or rows or anything because, again, everyone's different and you can make it whatever size or shape that you like. This is just a general guideline tutorial of how I make my crochet projects, but you could always switch it up here and there, make it your own, and yeah. Anywho, so yeah, that's pretty much it. You're just going to continue making your clusters of double crochet inside of the openings, and then you chain one, and then you reach on over to the next opening, and you make another four double crochets, and after that, you're going to chain one, reach on over to the next opening until you reach the end of the row. And once you reach the end of the row, if it's an opening, then you can go ahead and make your four double crochets inside of that opening. And then on your fourth double crochet, you're actually going to, instead of actually making it in the opening, you're going to make that fourth double crochet in the stitch underneath it. This will help make it stay rectangular. Otherwise, if you don't do this step right here, then it's going to start receding and you're going to start getting like a triangular project, and you don't want that for this cardigan. Maybe for other projects, but not this one. So from here, you're going to chain a total of three, and you're going to go over the first cluster from the, or rather the last cluster from the last row, and then you're going to go into the opening and then create your four double crochets inside of that opening. And what you've just created is, yes, a cluster of four, but also an opening at the end to keep with that pattern. See? Cluster, opening, cluster, opening. So that's what you're going to do. Every time you reach the end here and it ends on a cluster, then you're going to make sure that you make your fourth double crochet into the stitch underneath, and then build on top of it with three double crochets. And then go into the first opening. And then I'm just going to continue on completing my second row of the same color. So this time it is yellow. And after I am done with this row, I'm going to switch it on over to green. Also, like I mentioned earlier, I don't have orange yarn. But if you do have orange yarn, be sure that you use it after the red. So it goes red, orange, then yellow. I just, again, I don't have that color. I wish I did, because this would have been more rainbowy, but it's okay. So now that I have reached the end of the row, I'm going to change to my new color, which is green. And I know this is not like green green, but I wanted to use this yarn because I have like five of these and I wanted to use it up. And as you know, it's green enough. It's like a minty turquoise green. So I'm going to add that to my hook and then crochet with both the old color as well as the new color. And then I'm going to make my cluster of four double crochets inside of this first opening right here. And then continue on with the rest of the project. Now, for the sake of not boring you to death with the same thing over and over again, just me switching different colors but then doing the exact same thing, making my four double crochets inside of an opening, then chaining one, then going into the next opening and creating another four double crochets, I'm going to just show you pretty much the overall plan here so you know what to make. Because again, this all that I'm doing right now is all you need to know how to do in order to make the entire project. Because we're going to be making this in pieces and then we're going to slip stitch them all together at the end. And yeah, I know it sounds intimidating, but trust me, it's gonna be easy peasy. So, right now we're again working on the back portion of the cardigan. Now, the back portion of the cardigan is just one giant rectangle. The only part that's going to change is the top part right here. So it's going to be this giant rectangle and a smaller rectangle on top. Now, you may be wondering, how on earth am I going to make that little rectangle on top? Like, this is such an odd overall shape. Well, it's actually really easy. Okay, so pretty much I've shown you how I did this row, and then I left you on the green, right? Well, pretty much, again, all we're going to be doing is the exact same thing over and over again, just changing colors and then repeating the colors. So I have red, yellow, green, blue, purple, and then after purple, it's going to be red, yellow, green, blue, purple, and so on and so forth. And I'm going to make this whole part, which is, again, the back portion of the cardigan, the part that's actually going to cover my back. And then once we reach like my arm section, so this is all wrapping around like my torso, right? And once we reach the part where it's going to wrap around my arms, there needs to be space to actually put the sleeves in. So this needs to get smaller. So after you have made as many rows as you need in order for this to wrap around your back, just under your armpits, then you're going to, instead of going all the way to the end, you're going to attach your new color in the middle of this piece and then just crochet in the middle portion of it. Now you may be wondering what part is this. Basically, you're going to wrap this around your back under your armpits, and then you're going to need to still cover the your upper back and your the back of your neck kind of a little bit. So that's where this comes in. Just imagine this is going to be where the sleeves are going to go. You can't picture it, can you? Maybe after I crochet everything and I show you where everything gets sewn together, it will make more sense. But for now, this is the shape that you need to make, okay? You're gonna need to make a big rectangle. This is going to cover your back and all the way up to your armpits. So this should go right under your armpits. And then from there, you're going to find the middle section of the project, and you're going this is your back. And then once you wrap it around your back, this is your armpit, and this is under your arm. And then this should still be covering your back. I'll show you an example. Okay, like I was saying, this is the part that covers your back, right? So it's gonna cover from I wanted it chunky, so I want it longer. So it's kind of covering my butt to my armpit right here. See how it kind of wraps around? And then this portion, which is the smaller portion that you saw earlier, is going to wrap around my shoulder area, leaving this area open for me to attach the sleeve later. Does that all make sense? Now this, I kind of made it, again, a little bit too big because I want it chunky, but if you want it this big, then it's cool. If you want it more tighter fitting, then it could be a little less than this, maybe right here. Yeah, right there is good, because we're also going to be making the front portion. I already made mine. See, this is another piece, actually. After you make the back, you're going to make this front piece right here. We're going to make two of these. So it's going to be this one and then this one. And after that, then we're going to make the sleeves. And then we're going to attach those too. So right now, again, I made this piece already. So it kind of already looks like a vest. I just need to attach it right here. And then the sleeve. And there we go. So this is what you're working on right now. This is the back portion. So however long you want this to be, from underneath your armpit to wherever, that's how much you're going to crochet. And after you've reached this point, then that's when you change it up and you make it smaller, like I showed you earlier. And then after that, then you're done with the back piece. Then you can move on to this one. But first, let me finish off explaining the back piece. All right, back to you. See, I tried to warn you that the way I explain things and the way I crochet is different than anyone else. So hopefully it's not too frustrating for you. But yeah, that's pretty much what I did. This is what's covering my back all the way up to my armpit. And then once I reach my armpit, then I'm going to continue making it some more rows until it covers up to my neck. And then after that, I'm done with the back portion, and you can be too. Woo! Just remember to stick with the pattern and alternate the colors accordingly. There was a couple times where I mixed up the colors and I was like, no! And I had to unravel it and then add the right color and then start all over. But yeah, just make sure that your pattern is sound. And after you are done with this portion of the cardigan, then you can move on to either the sleeves or just actually follow what I'm doing and then actually move on to the step that I did next, which is the front piece. So for this, again, super easy. You grab your yarn and chain a chain that is long enough to cover from your hip to your belly button, or maybe 2 inches away from your belly button if you don't want it to close. If you do want it to close, then definitely from your hip to your belly button, but if you want it to stay open and not really ever close, then a couple inches away from your belly button is perfect. That's the way I'm making it, but if you want to make it so that maybe you can add buttons or something and actually close it up, then make sure that there's enough space from your hip to your belly button. And yeah, so this is going to be the front portion of the cardigan, and you're basically going to do the exact same thing that you did for the back, just with a smaller chain. So you're going to chain as many chains as you need, then go back on that chain and do the cluster of four double crochets, and you're gonna make two rows of one color, then switch the color and make two rows of that color, and then switch the color, and then do make two rows of that color, and then switch the color, and then make two rows of that color, then switch the color, then make two rows of that color, then switch the color, and so on and so forth until you've made a piece that is as long as the back piece, because you're going to attach them at the bottom, so they gotta be even. And you're also going to attach it at the top. So this is going to wrap around your shoulder, pretty much from your shoulder blade to your collarbone and down. So right now it kind of looks like a vest. I've just attached that top part, and the way I've attached it was just through slip stitch. So I just added the red yarn here, and then I just slip stitch both the pieces together. And yeah, so now it kind of looks like a vest. I know it's kind of hard to see because all the colors are like the same and they line up. But yeah, so later on I'm going to attach them right here, and then in this opening I'm going to attach the sleeves. So to make the sleeves now, so you're going to make two of these, so you're just going to make the exact same thing, and then attach it to this side, and so you're going to have two coming down right here, and it's going to be like a bona fide vest. If you want to keep it a vest, then that's how you make a vest. Woo, rainbow vest! But if you want to make it a cardigan like me, then you're going to also make the sleeves. And in order to make the sleeves, I actually want my sleeves to be nice and chunky. So when I first started out the sleeve, I grabbed my red yarn, because I'm always starting out with red just to keep the pattern going. I chained a chain that was not only long enough to wrap around my arm, maybe if you want a normal sleeve, then make a chain that's about this wide, or even tighter if you want like a tight sleeve. But for me, I wanted it chunky. So I made a chain about this long. That way when I wrap it around my arm, it's about this much bigger than I need it to be. but again, I want it chunky. So I chained a chain that long. And after that, I went ahead and continued on with the pattern I've been doing. And this is as far as I've gone along for my sleeve. But if I were to put it on, oh yeah, this is what it looks like when I'm actually working on it. It's just a giant rectangle. And then eventually I'm going to fold it over and then slip stitch it on the side. And then it's going to be a round project. So yeah, when it's round, it's going to look something like this. So I'm going to put my arm in here, and then kind of like close up to show you what it's going to look like. Yep, this is going to be my chunky sleeve. You can't really see it, it's kind of hard to show you. But yeah, it's going to be this much space in between. And I love it. It's going to be nice and chunky and super cozy. So if you want a chunky sleeve, then make a long chain. If you don't want a chunky sleeve, then make a short chain that's going to be tight like this if you want your sleeves nice and tight, but if you want them chunky, then make it nice and big so there's less space. What I probably might do too is I might do a couple rows of single crochet to kind of close this up so it's tight around my wrist but then chunky around my arms. But I'm getting ahead of myself. So we left off at the back, right? So after you finish your back, then you're going to make those two front pieces. So they're just like skinnier versions of the back piece that you made. And then after that, then you can work on your sleeve. So again, you're going to chain a chain that will wrap around your arms. Probably not this tight, a little looser than that. Totally up to you again. And then after you've made that chain, then you're going to go back on it with the red, and make two rows of red, then yellow, green, blue. Unless you have orange, then it's red, then orange, and yellow, then green and blue. until it's long enough to wrap around your entire arm, and then after that, then you're going to grab all of your pieces and you're going to attach them. So this is the back piece, this is the front piece, and then this will be the sleeve. And I know it looks like a crazy mess right now, but eventually it will make sense. This sleeve will be longer. There will be another this piece on the other side, so it will make more sense. And after that, then the finishing touches will probably be single crocheting a couple rows along this part and the neck portion, and then also making those couple rows of single crochet at the sleeve to tighten it around my wrist. And after that, then we will be done with the project. So I will check back in with you after I've fully completed all the pieces that we need, and then I'll show you where I attach each thing and then the finishing touches, and then we will be good to go. Okay, so we are back, and I'm going to show you all of the pieces in real time right here, but I'm also going to draw out what all the pieces are going to look like as well, because it's kind of hard to show you with all these like different colors going on, and then also just in general, it's hard to put everything in frame. So I'm just going to explain to you what all the pieces are, and then I'm going to draw it out, and hopefully that will make more sense. So first off, the back piece, like I mentioned earlier, is a large rectangle that will cover your back, and then a smaller rectangle in the middle of the giant rectangle from your armpit here to the back of your neck. So you just need one of these shapes, and then you're going to make two of the front pieces, which are just long and skinny rectangular pieces. And that's going to serve as the front portion of your cardigan. Yeah. So you're just going to make two of these. And then, finally, you're going to make the sleeves. And to make the sleeves, I just made two large rectangle pieces that cover my arm. So I crocheted it like this. So I made the I made the chain like so, however wide I wanted the sleeve to be, and then I continued making rows and rows and rows until it was long enough when I put my arm in it like so to actually cover my whole arm, and then this is what the sleeve will kind of look like. And yeah, so I just made two of these, and now it's time to put everything together. Okay, but actually first, let me draw everything out for you. Okay, so first step is to make this giant rectangle, right? You're just gonna make that giant rectangle from pretty much your hip bone to under your armpit. So when you wrap it around you, that's what it covers. And then once you reach that point, then you're going to make this little rectangle piece in the middle of that giant rectangle, right? And all in all, it should make this shape. Yes. So that's the first piece. And then I went ahead and made the two long pieces, and those are going to serve as the two front pieces for when you actually like wear it, that way it doesn't fall off. And I just made that by making smaller or thinner rectangle pieces, but pretty much doing the exact same thing. And I made two of those pieces, and then after I made those pieces, I made two larger rectangle pieces. Because again, I want big chunky sleeves. If you want smaller sleeves, then they don't have to be as large. Just make the original or the initial chain shorter than what I made. I made it pretty long, that way when I fold this rectangle in half, it will wrap around my arm and still have a lot of space. But if you want tighter sleeves, then when you wrap the project around your arm, it will be tighter. So it's totally up to you. Again, these are really wide because I want big, wide, chunky sleeves. So you're gonna make two of these larger rectangles, and we're going to put everything together by first, well, at least this is how I'm gonna do it. So first, I'm going to attach, or rather, I'm going to get the big piece, and I'm going to take the two thinner pieces and attach them right up here, as well as on the side right here. And after I do that, then I'm going to work on the sleeves. For the sleeves, I'm going to fold them in half and then attach them right here. And when I say attach, I'm doing everything with a slip stitch. So I just, whatever I want to attach together, I put them together and then slip stitch in between the two. So after I have attached the sleeves to itself to actually make it a sleeve and like circular instead of rectangular, then I'm going to grab the sleeves and attach them where the sleeves should be attached to, right here in the opening. And after that, I'm pretty much done with the cardigan. So I've actually already attached this one. So I just gotta attach this one over here. And I decided to go with the red yarn. Red yarn will be my stitching yarn. No particular reason, it's just what I'm going to use. And I'm trying to decide what is like a front and what is a back. So there you go, I've decided. This is going to be it. So I'm just going to line up where I want the two pieces to be attached. And then I'm going to attach my yarn. Oh, I'm like in the sun, weird. Attach my yarn to the hook and then go through both sides of the project and just slip stitch. I know the beginning looks a little bit complicated because that's when I'm adding the yarn, but after that it's nice and easy. You just go into one stitch, so blue stitch for one side, the red stitch for the other side, and you just join them together with a slip stitch. Through one stitch, through the second stitch of the other side, join them together with a slip stitch. One stitch, two stitch, slip stitch. And yeah, that's pretty much all I do to attach them. I don't know if there's really any other way that other people attach them, but if you have a better method, then go ahead and do that. But this is what I'm gonna do. And yeah, so after I'm done attaching this piece on the top, I'm going to go to the side again. And I'm going to attach it to the side like I showed you in the drawing. And then I'm going to slip stitch the sleeves together so that they're round. And then I'm going to slip stitch them onto the actual project. Okay, so I've officially attached the top piece right here. So now I'm going to go to the sides and attach them together like so. I'm just going to be slip stitching on this side and then go to the other side, line it up, and then slip stitch that together too, so it'll be a full-on vest. Voila! This is a rainbow vest. So again, I have attached the top portion as well as the sides right here, and you may be thinking, that looks hideous. Well, I'm going to flip everything inside out once I'm done, and you won't be able to see the stitching as much. I mean, obviously you can still see it, especially because I used red yarn. But yeah, all of these like things sticking out, that's going to be inside out, so you can't see it. But yeah, if you wanted to make a rainbow vest, then you are done. But if you want sleeves on this, then let's move on to the sleeves. But just really quick, this is what it looks like so far. Yes, I am in my pajamas, and yes, this is a different day. That's why I'm wearing a different shirt. But yeah, so this is what it looks like as a vest if you wanted to stop here. But if you want to do a cardigan like me, let's go on to the sleeves. Alrighty, so as I mentioned earlier, we are going to have two rectangular pieces and we're going to fold them over like so and then attach them right here. So then once they're attached, it's going to be a rounded project instead of a rectangular project. And after that, then we are going to attach them to the actual vest and then I will get back to you. Alrighty, so I have attached the sleeves, so now they are round pieces. So again, I just folded the rectangular pieces and then attached the two ends together. That way it could be like an actual sleeve. Yay! So now the final step is to attach these sleeves to the vest here. So there's gonna be an opening right here where your sleeves are gonna go, and you're just gonna boop, attach them like so. Yay, okay, so officially everything is nice and attached to one another, and this is what it looks like on the inside. So now I'm going to make it right side in. That way you won't see all of the stitching that is done when it's inside out. And when you're putting everything together, make sure that you have everything inside out. So then when you flip it back over, it looks nice and crisp. So yeah, this is what the cardigan looks like. Yay! And I'm still not sure if I'm going to actually add that layer of, or rather those couple rows of like single crochet right here. But if I do, and you see it in the ending clip, then that's what I did. I just added a few rows of single crochet just to clean it up a bit. And yeah, so that's how I crocheted this rainbow cardigan. I really love the way that it turned out. It's so chunky and cute and bright and colorful. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this kind of tutorial, more like a guide of what I did to crochet this. But regardless, I hope you enjoyed it, found it either interesting, entertaining, or helpful. And if you did, please give a big thumbs up before you go. And also check out all my other crochet tutorials that I have on this channel. The further back you go on my channel, the more beginner friendly all my tutorials are. But the newer ones are very, very fast just because I've been doing this for years and it gets really repetitive. But if you do want to use this as a tutorial and I did go really fast for you, you could always slow down the video and also rewatch the video. So yeah, thank you again for watching. If you enjoyed it, please give a big thumbs up before you go. I think I already said that, but yeah. I would say subscribe for more crochet tutorials, but honestly, I share crochet tutorials like randomly when I get sparks of inspiration. My spark of inspiration was actually my rainbow nails. And also the fact that I've always wanted a rainbow cardigan anyway, but still, every couple months or so, I share a crochet tutorial. So if you're here for just crochet, just know that. I don't post them regularly anymore, but if you are interested in character-inspired fashion, I do share a lot of those kinds of videos and Disney videos, probably Disney vlogs once Disneyland actually opens up. But yeah, just check out my channel, see if you like it, and if you do, don't forget to click that red subscribe button if you have not already, so I can see you next time. Bye, and have a magical day.